Isitjhaba siyalila ngesiqunto seNersa sokuvumela i-Eskom ukuthi ikhuphule intengo yegezi. Bathi banevalo lokuthi isiqundwesi sizokuthinda kumbi abantu abavele batlhaga ngonobangela wokubiza kwepilo. Kanti kulindeleke ukuthi kukhuphuke nentengo yeensetshenziswa eziningi nasele kunje.
We believe that anything beyond inflationary increase, which we think Eskom can reasonably get, is just simply punishing the consumers for lack of efficiency and uncontrollable losses at Eskom.
Ihlanganisela yamayunion ikhosathu ithi itshwenyekile ngombana abasebenzi bazokudosa nzima.
Workers don't receive 18% increases. They're lucky to receive an inflation increase at all, which is at about 7%, and that's if they get an increase. But workers are highly indebted, they're supporting relatives who are unemployed, who won't find jobs easily.
Umxozululo wezamandla uyelelise ngokuthi ukukhuphuka kwegezi kuzokukhuthaza ukwetshiya kwegezi begodu kuzokwenza nokuthi abantu babhalelwe ukubhadela izenzelwa.
I do believe that by putting up the price like this, there are diminishing returns for Eskom because more and more people will not be able to pay. And you cannot get blood out of a stone, much as you squeeze it.
Isazi sezamandla uCarol Stein uthi ukukhutshulwa kwegezi kanengi akusiso isisombululo somraro wegezi.
Renewable energy will help, but it takes too long to implement. It's usually not enough when it's implemented. And we need solutions urgently. And renewables takes time to implement.
Nakusenjalo, i-Eskom ithi iyasamukela isiqondo seNersa. Ithi ukukhutshulwa kwegezi lokhu kuzokusiza ekuqiniseni ubujamo bemali zekampani le. Kanti i-Eskom inxanxabezile godu ngokuraga nokuqindelisa igezi.